So you want to change the color of a texture in Unity. First, prepare the texture. In your image editing program, desaturate the texture and adjust the levels so the texture is close to white. White pixels can be multiplied with a color to get any color you want. In the content browser, create a new shader of type PBR graph and name it Pick Color. Start with the node to use the texture you just made. Create a sample texture 2D. Next, create a texture 2D asset to plug into the sample texture node. Right-click the texture asset and convert to property. Properties are like public variables, which means they can be changed outside of this shader. This shader needs two properties, one property to set the texture, and the second property to set the color. For that, use a vector1 node, which is simply one floating point number. Create the vector1 node, then right-click to convert to property. Now take a minute to rename the properties. Properties are edited in the Blackboard panel. If you don't see this panel, there's a bug in Unity, and you can fix this by going to Layout in the top right and Revert Factory Settings. You will lose any custom layout you have, but the Blackboard will show up, allowing you to edit properties. Name the texture property Diffuse. Assign a default texture. And most importantly, change the reference name of the vector1 to be Hue. The reference name will be used to set this property later. Create a Hue node. This node allows you to define a starting color with R, G, and B values. Set the value of X to be 1, so you start with red. The offset value will then shift hue without changing the saturation or brightness. You can define a hue with any number between 0 and 360. Multiply the vector1 node, now called hue, by 360. Multiply the output of the sample texture with the output of the hue node and connect the result to albedo. A white texture multiplied by the color red equals a red texture. Select the material and assign the shader you just made. Now make a simple user interface to drive the color change. Create a UI slider. Don't need any fancy transitions. Go from bottom to top and position it where you want it. You don't need fill area. Great, the slider slides. You will need a script on the slider to communicate with the shader you just made, so create a new C# script named SetColor. Don't need all that. Declare a material that will change color. Declare a slider that will control the color change. And finally, declare the hue. Now, by default, the script doesn't know what a slider is, so make sure to include UnityEngine.ui. In start, get the slider component, which will be on the same game object as this script. Now create a function that will change the color. And make sure it's public so you can call it from anywhere. Set the color to the value of the slider. Then use the SetFloat command to set the hue property of the shader. Save your script and fix any errors. Add the SetColor script to the slider, then assign the material you want to change the color of. Add a function call where it says onValueChanged. Since the script is on the same game object, assign the slider to itself, then use the drop-down menu to navigate to the GetColor function. And voila! But that's not all. Make another shader. This time, instead of PBR graph, choose Unlit graph. Name it Gradient. Make another hue node, starting at red. Make a UV node, which is basically two gradients. Split the UV node to get one of those gradients. Multiply by 360. And connect everything to get a gradient of all the colors. Make a new material for the gradient. Assign this material to the background of the slider. Now return to the SetColor script. Declare a new variable for the handle. This hue variable probably doesn't need to be public. For now, just hide it in the inspector. In the getColor function, declare a new color variable and use the HSVToRGB command to assign the color from the hue. This command is almost the same as the hue node you used in the shader. Finally, get the image component of the handle, which itself has a color component, and assign the color. Save your script and fix any errors. A new public variable has appeared, so assign the slider's handle. And now the handle changes color too.